Hello everyone. This small tutorial will take you through a digital resources portion of Emirates Private School website. I'll be showing you how to upload your data for e-learning process for the students. So to start with, the first and foremost thing what you need is the portal username and password. Now just to make it clear, if anybody who doesn't have the username and a password can't go ahead with the process. So the people responsible for putting the data for the students online must be having a username and a password. In case if you don't have the username and a password, whatsoever reason it is, send me a message on WhatsApp, or you can contact Ms. Azza, Ms. Maimuna or Ms. Nagla regarding the same, and we'll try to figure it out how to get you the username and a password. Well, to start with the process, we'll be using a browser to access the digital resources area. Now it doesn't matter which browser do you use. It can be Internet Explorer, Microsoft Edge, Firefox, Safari, Google Chrome, whatever you're comfortable with. I'll be using Google Chrome for this process. So let's start with it. After you open the browser, on the address bar, type in the website address, which will be www.epschad.com. Hit the enter button. You will come to the website of Emirates Private School. Now from here onwards, you will be going and clicking on the user login, where you will see student login, teachers login and admin login. Now this video tutorial is for the teachers, so go and click on a teachers login. You'll be redirected to a page of Horizon, which is the school management system which Emirates Private School is using. Most of you are aware of this. So let's type in the username. I'll be using mine. Now you have to make sure you have to add @emiratesprivates.com along with it, otherwise your username is not complete. Go ahead and type in the password. And then people who want to use Arabic, go ahead and use Arabic, or I'll be continuing with the English part. So let's select the language and hit the login button. Now once you log into your portal, this interface, most of you who have been logged in or who have been using the email services and rest of the things are aware of. I will come to the rest of the part of it as and when required. There will be other videos also which will teach you how to do the rest of the things. For the time being, we'll be continuing with the digital resources. So on the left hand side panel, if you see, you'll be having something, or you'll be looking for something called as an academics. Once you click on the academic, you will be having the first link over here which talks about control panel 1. Click on control panel 1, the page refresh, and you will be moving on to the another page where it will show you certain document. In case if you come across this particular page, you don't have to do anything. Don't put the username and a password all over again. Just click here, have troubled in view, and click OK, because certain browsers will have an issue. So you can just click over here and it will take you to the place where it's supposed to be. Now once you come on this particular page, you will see there is a digital resources weekly plan and weekly plan report. Now technically this thing will not come for everybody, especially the weekly plan report, because weekly plan report is for only the head of the departments. Otherwise rest of the people will have the digital resources and the weekly plan. Well, we'll come back to this again. Going back to the digital resources, once you click on the digital resources, now this is the area of digital resources. So what you'll be doing is you'll be creating a category over here. Under that you'll be adding a subcategory. Now what is the category? Possibly it will be your class or sections or subject, whatever you want to be. But here I want to tell you, try to be as explanatory as you can, because this will help. As this is a pilot project, it will help the students also to understand how to go about it. Let's take an example and we'll continue on that. Click add category. I'm clicking over here, and then we'll come to something called as a new category. Here type in a new category. I'm For example, I'll be teaching IGCSE grade 10. So let's say grade 10 sections I'm talking about A and B. Now make sure you don't use any special characters, for example backslash or comma or full stop, something like that. It might have a conflict with the coding part. So you can use the hyphens or dash. So grade 10 A and B. If you want to be more specific, I'm typing here ICT. Under that you have something called as a nest category under. I'm leaving it as a default one and I click the save button. Now once this data is saved, you have to search here where did you created the category. Now if you see over here, I can see the category which I created is grade 10 A and B ICT. I have to create under this another subcategory which will talk about the chapter, the lesson, the topic, whatever you want to put it across. So let's go back and create a add category and a subcategory button again. Now here I'm typing over here, let's say for example this is my lesson 1 of chapter 8 and I am typing the name of the chapter, the topic of the chapter called as analysis, or let's say system analysis. And now under the next category I click over here, I will go and select the category which I created, grade 10 A B ICT. It should be under this category and hit the save button again. Now let's go and have a look at it. It will show something like this, grade 10 A and B ICT, lesson 1, chapter 8, system analysis. Once you are up till here, you have created your category, you have created your subcategory. Now we'll be going and adding a content to the subcategory. So click on view category content. Once I'm clicking over here, you will be again redirected to a page where it will give you an option to add the categories. Now I'm going and adding, click on add button. We'll start with the title. My title of the chapter is System Analysis. Digital Resources, I'm skipping at this part over here. I'll copy the same topic in the short description. I put the same thing as System Analysis. Now, I'm sure there will be some instruction which will be going to the students by the teacher. That will be writing it over here. Now, before I write that instruction, I have organized certain data for my grade 10, so I will show you how it's going to be. These are all the sample data, so it is not the actual data. Under this you can see there is something called as a multiple attachment. So now click over here and I will be moving on to something over here where I have stored all the data as a sample data. Resources. First thing is my explanation file, something I'm talking about that particular chapter. So I select this file, then I have a worksheet file, and then I have a quiz file. So I'm selecting all these three files over here and I click on open. Now all these files are added over here. Now once the files are added, based on the file name I will be writing the instruction. This is my way of explanation. You can name the file as 123 ABC, whatever you think your student can understand better. As I said, keep the file names and the description as clear as it can be. So here if I'm talking about, I'll write the chapter number and topic. Now what they'll be doing over here, I will put that part. So now I have given three files over there. So let's say this is the first file they should be going through. So I copy the name of this file. It's very simple, you just right click over here, rename, and then right click copy. Once you copy the name of the file, Then you come back and you paste it here. I will write the description after some time. Go back. This is the worksheet they should be doing it. So again, we'll go to the same process, and then I'm pasting it here. And the third file of mine will be the quiz. So I'll be pasting it here. Now I write the description for this file. This is read through the file for explanation of the digital resources. This one, complete the worksheet, and then so these are my instructions. Make sure you don't forget to write your name, because the students will be replying back to you with the assignments or whatsoever. So I'm just selecting this one, and let's do a little formatting over here if you want to do that way. I prefer to have it little formatted. So I'm going with some bullets, and all the headings I'm making it as a bold. Now this is what I want the student to do. Coming back, this is assigned to grade 10 A and B only. So I will be going and selecting the option who will be seeing this. In the search I type 10, and I have to check on 10A and 10B. These are the only class. Please make sure nothing else is selected, otherwise that will be, this particular thing will be assigned to that class as well, and the students will get confused. So select only the class which you want them to have access to this. So it says to selected. Now after you do this, let's say I have certain video resources also which I need to show. So I go on YouTube and I search for a relevant video, system analysis. Well, let's say this is the who is chapter 1 introduction of system analysis. Let's talk about this particular video. So I'll open this video. Now this is the video I want them to see. What I do is I stop this video. I'm sure we will be checking this video first for the resources, and then only we will be coming and creating this particular thing what we are doing over here. So now once I have this particular thing here, you have a share option. Click on share, and you have an embed option. Click on embed. Once you click on embed, on the right hand side you can see there is a code. So from the start of this till the end of it, just make sure you copy it. Once you copy it, go back to the reports, and you will be finding a same icon over here which is called as a source code. Click on the source code. These are the content you have already written. So after this, press an enter and paste the code, the one which you have copied from the YouTube share, and click OK. Now along with this, your video is embedded within the page. After this, just go and hit the save button. Your digital resources has been updated or uploaded for chapter 1 or lesson 1, chapter 8 system analysis, and it is assigned only to grade 10A and 10B. I'll be doing another video where I'll be showing you how the student will access this. So you can have a look at that one also. Thank you very much for your time. In case if anybody has a question, again, there are multiple videos which will be coming in. So check anything which is there in the link. And if anyone has a question, let me know.